everyone, welcome to Aptitude Guru Him. So let's get into our verbal sessions. Before that, kindly answer your attendance and get back to us soon. I'll be waiting for you. Day by day, the attendance is going very down, so I want all of you to come and join. Please, verbal sessions are very, very important, okay? Please answer your attendance and get back soon, please. We shall wait for another 30 seconds and we shall get started, okay? Okay then, let's move into our today's topic. We'll start with parajumbles. What are parajumbles? Parajumbles are nothing but sentence rearrangement. This is a very simple topic where we can easily score marks. But to score marks, you have to follow a few tips and tricks. Let's see what are the tips and the tricks for solving parajumbles. Number one. Look for the sentences that clearly introduces a person, a place, committee, or concept in the para jumble. That will most likely be the opening sentence. So to find the opening sentence, what we have to look for? We have to look for the sentences that clearly introduces a person, a place, a committee, or a concept. So tip number one is to look for the sentences that clearly introduces a person, a place, committee, or a concept. Number two, always spot the central theme of each para jumble. The flow of the story or dialogue goes a long way in placing together the para in the correct order. So always look for the central theme of each para. Okay? Let's go to tip three. Follow the activities. At times, para jumble will have activities. In such cases, by just analyzing which of the activities happen when, the question can be solved easily. So tip number three is to follow the activities. Tip four, connectives. There will be sentences having connectives like although, however, if, until, besides, yet, because, consequently, notwithstanding, and then, meanwhile, so, whenever, whatever, wherever, therefore, etc. These connectives will help us in solving the para jumbles. So when you look into a sentence, look for the connectives too. Number five, articles. Articles can also help us in answering a para jumbles question. The denotes something or someone specific, or when the person or the thing for which the article has been already introduced. While a or an is used to introduce something or someone specific. So, when you have already mentioned someone or something, we would have used the. When we are going to introduce someone, then we use a or an. So, this is a very important tip. Tip number six, pronouns. Similarly, pronouns like he, she, they, them, etc. are indicators. If your sentence starts with a pronoun, it definitely can't be your first sentence. Mostly it can be your first sentence, okay? If a sentence starts with a pronoun, it is not definitely, it mostly can't be your first sentence. Okay, at times it will also start with a pronoun. Tip number seven, adjectives. Adjectives like simpler, better, cleverer, smarter, etc. are comparatives. Hence, they hold relationship to other things. They will to help us in solving para jumbles. So, let's go from back. What are the seven tips? Adjectives, pronouns, articles, connectives, follow the activity, find the central theme, and look for the sentence which introduces a place, a person, a committee, or a concept. So, here is question number one on the screens for you. This is having four statements. So, this should be solved within 4 minutes maximum. But, I request all of you to solve this within a minute. So, let me pause for a minute. Give a try to solve this question. Try to implement the 7 tips in this to solve the question. It's a very simple question. Try to focus on the question and answer. Just read the 4 sentences and then try to look into the option. Okay? So that you can find the central theme too. Statement 1. says 1971 war changed the political geography of the subcontinent. Number 2. Despite the significance of the event, there has been no serious book about the conflict. Number 3. Surrender at Dhaka aims to fill this gap. Number 4. It has profoundly altered the geostrategic situation of Southeast Asia. Now try to answer this question. Try to focus on the central theme. Look for the pronouns, if any. Look for connectives, if any. Okay? I'll be answering this question in another 10 seconds. Very good. I have seen few people answering. Very good, very good, very good. I want all of you to answer in the live chat. You can drop your answers in the live chat. Okay. See, by reading the statement, we can very easily find that the sentence should start with option 1. That is the statement 1. Now that we know that 1 is the starting sentence, we can eliminate option B and C. That is choice B and C, as they start with 3 and 2. Okay. This narrows down a possibility to option A and B, right? Sorry, A and D. Now we can see in option A, 3 follows sentence 1. But the gap spoken of in the sentence 3 has no relation with political geography of the subcontinent spoken of in sentence 1. So we can rule out option A. Therefore, answer has to be option D, as we can also see it elaborates on the change mentioned in sentence 1, right? So answer would be option D. So answer would be option D. So we'll be having these two options, so we can cut off these. So answer would be option D. The question, the explanation, and the answer is on the screens for you now. I shall display it for 30 seconds and we shall move to the next question. Very simple, na? So, find the central theme, apply the pronouns, try to find the connectivity, and we shall be able to solve things. Okay, then well, let's move on to the next question. Try to think and answer. Try to apply the same rules. Okay? Read the sentences carefully and answer. I'll give you exactly a minute to solve this question too. I want all of you to answer in the live chat. Very good. Come on, guys. Come on. Start thinking and try to answer the question. Very simple. Read all the four statements and then proceed. What is the four statements given? His political career came to an abrupt end with China's military operation. He attracted as well as rippled. It is not as rippled. It would be as well as rippled. Okay. He was responsible for the debacle. What is the meaning of the debacle? Debacle means failure. Okay. A man of paradoxes, meaning, reminder, enigma. Now try to answer. I hope you guys know the meaning of the word enigma as well. Enigma means a person or thing that is difficult to understand. Now try to solve this. Now try to solve it. This is very, very easy. In another 10 seconds, I will be giving the answer. Very simple. Keep trying, folks. Keep trying. Give a try. Okay. This is all about one person, right? So the statement should be, the opening statement should be, a man of paradoxes, meaning, reminder, enigma, right? A man of paradoxes is continued by, repelled and attracted. Okay, so it should be, so the second statement should be, he attracted as well as repelled. Okay, subsequently, the debacle refers to China's flawed military operation. Okay, so statement one, his political career came to an abrupt end with China's military operation, should be the statement three. So the choice would be option C. Sorry, the choice would be choice C, 4, 2, 1, 3. So the order would be, a man of paradoxes, meaning, reminder, and enigma. Then he attracted as well as repelled. Then the next would be one, right? One is, his political career came to an abrupt end with China's military operation. And then the next would be, he was responsible for the debacle. So answer would be choice C. Okay, this word was a clue as well. The question, the answer, and the explanation is given on the screens for you right now. So we shall move to the next question in another 30 seconds. Okay. I hope it was easy for us to resolve after trying with the tips, right? So this question was much easier than the previous question, no? So then let's move on to our next question. Try to answer this question. The sentences are big, but the answer would be very easy, I believe. Okay, try to solve. The potential exchanges between the officials of IBBF and the Maharashtra Bodybuilding Association has all the trappings of the drama we are accused to. Accustomed to. Next. In the case of sports person, there is room for some sympathy, but the empathy of the administrators, which has even led to the sanctions from the international bodies, is unpardonable. The case in the point is the FT penalty of US dollar 10,000 slapped on Indian body building penetration for not filling its commitment for holding Asian Championships in Mumbai in October. It is a matter of deep regret and concern that sports administrators often cause harm to the image of the country than sportsmen and sportswomen do through their dismal performances. Try to answer this. Try to answer. It's very simple actually. Try to answer. Fine. Another 10 seconds I shall give the answer for this. Okay. Okay, let me try to answer this. Option B would be the correct for this. Here, sentence 3 is examples of sentence 4. Therefore, 3 will come after 4. Now, as we go by elimination method, only B and C remains. Now, go by acronym method. IBBF in sentence 1 and Indian Bodybuilding Federation in sentence 3. It's a clue, right? Therefore, sentence 3 will come before sentence 1 as full form of the word is stated in sentence 3. And only afterwards, short form is used in the sentence. Hence, only option B remains to be the correct answer. So the answer would be option B. Answer would be option B. That is, it is a matter of deep regret would be the first statement, and the next statement would be, in the case of sports person, there is a room of some sympathy. Then the next statement followed would be the potential exchanges between the officials of IBBF, and the last statement, third statement would be a case in a point is a FT penalty of $10,000, and the last statement would be the potential exchange between the officials of IBBF. So the question and the answer is now on the screens for you. We shall move to the next question in another 30 seconds. Okay, I hope it's very clear. I know a few people will be asking why it's not, it's starting with a pronoun. The rules itself, I told that mostly it will not with a pronoun, it will not start with a pronoun. But the entire concept is talking about the deep regret and concern towards the sport administrators. Okay, it's totally about it. So we are starting with statement 4. So our choice would be option B, choice B. I hope you guys get it. Right, so let's move on to the next question. Now try to solve this question. This question has got 5 statements, so I will give you 1.5 minutes to solve. Okay, it is a very, very simple question. Try to solve it. What is given over the years, I have had the opportunity to absorb and understand the thought process behind the ads that have been flooding both the print and TV media. Although there is a huge shift in the quality of ads that we come across on a daily basis, thanks essentially to improvement in technology, I somehow can't help but feel that the quality of communication of the messages has become diluted. Proportionally, the number of ads that lack in quality have gone exponentially as well. There is an increasing attempt by most companies to be seen as cool and funky. Another reason could be burgeoning number of companies, which means an exponential increase in the number of ads that are being being made. Now, what is the meaning of the word burgeoning? It means a rapid increase. It's a rapid increase. Now try to solve. Very simple. I'll give you the answer in another 10 seconds. It's a very, very simple thing. Look about the theme. Look for the theme. Find the theme and you can answer this. So he's going to continuously talking about the ad. Who is talking and what? Just think and answer. Okay, anyways, let me answer. The answer would be option C. It's because the individual is explaining his perception. So it should begin with option, option 1. So the choice would be C. It should be 1, 2, 4, 5, 3. Right, it would be 1, 2, 4, 5, 3. So what is our statement 1? Over the years, I have had an opportunity to observe and understand the thought process behind the ads that have been flooding both print and TV media. Okay, so it's very easy. With this flow, we can continue. The only option which starts with option C, option 1 is choice C. So our answer is choice C. Right? So let me display the question and the answer for you. And we shall move to the next question in another 10 seconds. I hope this is very, very easy, right? Okay, let's move on to the next question. Try to solve this. It's having only four sentences, so we shall have only 1 minute for solving this question. To get a head start, early the next morning, the farmer started covering ground quickly because he wanted to get as much as land he could. Late in the afternoon, he realized the condition he had to fulfill to get the land was to get back to starting point by sundown. Even though he was tired, he kept all going because he did not want to miss this once in a lifetime opportunity to gain more wealth. That is a story about wealthy who was once offered all the land he could work in a day, provided he come back by sundown to a point where he started. So try to answer this question. It's a very simple question. In another 20 seconds, I will give the answer for this question. But keep trying, guys. Keep trying. It's very simple. You know which will be the starting sentence, right? The starting sentence would be... Okay, let me say. The starting sentence would be option 4. That is a story about the wealthy. Okay, then you can continue. What should follow then? Okay, so the answer is option C. 1 comes after 4 as it follows the story beginning in 4. 3 follows 4. The time factors mentioned in the statement is indicative of this. 2 concludes the process and reveals the mistake. So answer would be 4, 1, 3, 2. So the choice would be C, 4, 1, 3, 2. That is a story about a wealthy. Then the next statement would be, to get a head start early the next morning, the farmer started Then the next statement would be C. Even though he was tired, he kept going on. Then last statement would be late in the afternoon, he realized the condition he had to fulfill to get was to get back to the starting point by sundown. Okay, so the answer is option C. Right? Answer is option C. So the question and the answer is now on the screens for you. In another 10 seconds, we shall move to the next question. Okay? I hope this was very simple. Right? This was very simple. So let's move on to our next question in another 5 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. The next question. I'll try to answer this. Sony has been valued at around rupees 800 crores. It won't be crore, it would be crores. IBM is a leading consultancy firm. This valuation has been done by IBM. They have relied on the excess value approach. Now try to find the answer. It's very, very simple. Come on, folks, you can do it. Very, very simple, very, very simple. I'll give you the answer in another 10 seconds. But give a try. It's very simple, but give a try. Okay, the answer would be option D. That is 1, 3, 2, 4. Choice D would be correct because, the sentence can start with 2 or 1. But 1 and 2 are vice versa, right? And can't follow each other. Thus, second option is out. So, we can start with option A. The sentence 1 will be followed by 3. As it talks about who did the valuation. So, the answer would be option D, 1, 3, 2, 4. That is, so what is our first statement? Sony has been valued at around rupees 800 crores. And the next statement would be this valuation has been done by IBM. And the next would be IBM is a leading consultancy. And 4, they have relied on excess value approach. Fine. Very simple now. Very simple, right? So next question and the answer is given for you on the screen. And in another 20 seconds, we shall move to the next question. So the entire concept is about the Sony's valuation. So that is our opening sentence. I hope you guys understand. Fine. If you have any doubt, you can drop down after the class is over. In the sense, after your final attendance, you can drop down in the live chat. I'll be there to explain to you. Fine? Okay, now let's move on to the next question. Now try to answer this. Even as India's leftist think Bill Clinton is coming to take over India, Indian companies are preparing to take over American ones. Now Infosys and Wipro propose 54,000 crore each. To put this in perspective, recall that when Chandan sold his Parley brands to Coca-Cola amidst with Swadeshi wringing of hands. He got reported 200 crores. Infosys and Wipro, our two most glamorous infotech companies, but want automatic permission from FIPB to to take over foreign companies worth, hold your breath, $15 billion each. Try to answer. I'll give you a minute. A minute is actually too much for this question, but still. If you hear any other voice in between, again, I'm really sorry. Try to answer. Think and answer. This is all about what? What would be the starting sentence? Okay, now let's look into the answer for this question. Fine. The answer would be 1, 4, 3, 2. Sentence 2 cannot be initiating sentence. It cannot be the initiating sentence because a continuation of statement 3, that is 3-2. Similarly, 1-4 forms a logical pair. So, answer would be 1-4-3-2. That is, even as Indian leftist. And then the next statement would be Infosys and Wipro. Our two most glamorous info tech. Then the next statement would be, what is number statement 3? To put this in perspective, and then the next statement should be, now Infosys and Wipro propose 54,000 each. So answer would be 1-4-3-2. 1-4-3-2. The question and the answer is displayed on the screens now. In another 20 seconds, we shall move to the next question. Not 20 seconds, not 10 seconds is enough, right? In another 10 seconds, we shall move to the next question. Fine. I think para jumbles is easy for you guys. I guess so. Okay, let's move on to the next question now then. Try to solve this. It's very easy. Try to solve this question. What is the question? Mr. Gautam's personality sets him apart the rest. Nothing is too small for his attention. He has a fanatical devotion to detail. This is what makes him a different guy. Right answer, very simple. In another 10 seconds, I shall give the answer to this question. It's very simple, but still I want you guys to answer. It's very, very simple. So, you know what would be the starting sentence? The starting sentence would be Mr. D. Gautam's personality sets him apart the rest. So, that would be our starting sentence. So, what would be following? So, option C and D can be eliminated. You guys know that C and D can be eliminated. Right? Now tell me what would be the answer. So the answer would be followed by 3. The answer would be option A. So followed by statement 1 should be 3. As it refers E in that statement. It is mentioned that he has a fanatical devotion to detail. And after this, the statement would be nothing is small to his attention. Then this is what makes him a different guy. So answer is 1-3-1-3-2-4. Answer is 1-3-2-4. Answer is 1, 3, 2, 4. The question and the answer is here on the screens for you. In another 10 seconds, we shall move to the next question. Okay? Okay, then let's move on to the next question. Try to solve this. Very simple. Food manufacturers spend more on advertising than any other manufacturing group, and national grocery stores rank first among retailers. Food products lead in expenditures for network and sport television advertisement, discount coupon, trading stamps, contest, and other form of premium advertising. Foods are overwhelming the most advertised group of all consumer products in the US. In other media, newspapers, magazines, newspapers, supplements, billboard, and radio, food advertising expenditures rank near the top. Now try to answer. It's very, very simple. We're talking about what we know. Try to answer then. Think and answer, folks. Think and answer. Think and answer. Okay, let me give the answer then. Answer would be option B. Okay. 2 follows 3 as it confirms the information of the statement in 3. Logically, more the advertisement, more the expenses. In the fourth statement, the expenditure mentioned in advertising on food products is further elaborated. One sums up the thought. Thus, B would be the correct answer. So, B is 3, 2, 4, 1. B is 3, 2, 4, 1. That is, foods are overwhelming the most advertised group of all consumer products in the US. And the next would be food products lead in expenditures. And then the next would be in other media, newspapers, magazines. And the last statement would be food manufacturers spend more on advertising. So answer would be option B. The question and the answer is given to you on the screen. Okay, guys, I would like to talk about Make Way for Students program. Mr. Danush Kumaran's program is already telecasted. It's already been broadcasted through our channel. And I want a lot of you people to participate as well. There are a few entries from SRM Institute of Science and Technology. First year students are very interested to participate in this. I want all of you guys to give a try. Okay, does not matter. Just give a try. Fine. Give a try, and if you're interested, you can post to akshayhemchandra@gmail.com or you can ping me in WhatsApp or Telegram group. Fine. I want at least 10 entries, 10 participants today. I want at least 10 people to contact me and ask that, ma'am, I want to participate in Make Way for Students. Let's see. Oh. Okay, then let's move on to our next topic. Our next topic is analogies. Actually, analogies is a very simple topic. At times, it's the most difficult topics as well. The answer should match with the author's perspective. So, according to me, analogies is a risky topic, but we have to definitely try to attend. In case if your exam is not going to have any negative marks, I will request you guys to answer the questions in analogies. Fine. So let's go on to our question number one. Very simple. Petal is to flower. Then what would be the answer? Petal is to flower. Options are on the screen. I'll give you 30 seconds because you have to think logically. You have to think logically and answer for this. Think properly, logically, and answer for this question. That is very, very, very important. Think logically. Petal is to flower. Excuse me, sorry about the sound. Which will logically sound closer to this? Petal is to flower, then what would be the answer, folks? Think, think, think. Okay, what is a petal? Petal is a part of a flower, right? Then what would be the part of what? Will it be salt is to pepper? Will it be salt is to pepper? No. Will it be base is to ball? No. Will it be sandal is to shoes? No. Will it be puppy is to dog? No. The answer is tire is to bicycle. Okay, so petal is a part of a flower. So similarly, tire is a part of a bicycle. The question and the answer is displayed to you on the screens now. In another 10 seconds, we shall move to the next question. It's very simple, no? At times it will be very confusing. That's why, huh? Next, fish is to school. Then what is to what? Fish is to school. Then what is to what? Try to answer. Very simple. What is the relationship between fish and school? What is the relationship between them? Okay, a group of fish is known to be a school. Then a group of wolves is known to be what? It's known to be a pack. Okay, a group of fish is known to be a school. Then a group of which animal is known to be what? Then the exact pair would be wolf is to pack. It is not elephant is to jungle. It's not option D, C, or E. The answer is option A, wolf is to pack. What is the relationship? Group of fish is known to be school. Okay, the question and the answer is on the screens for you right now. We shall move to the next question in another 10 seconds. Fine. So let's move on to the next question now. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Jaundice is to liver. Then what is to what? Jaundice is to liver. Then what is to what? Imagination to brain or valentine to heart, smoke to lung or dialysis to kidney or rash to skin. Try to answer, folks. Easy, na? Very easy. Come on, come on, come on. Actually, 1 minute is too much for these questions, but still, think and answer. See, logically, narrow down to two options. Try to think which is more applicable and answer the question. Fine. So in another 10 seconds, I'll reveal the answer for this question. Very simple. So let me give the answer for this question. Okay, what is jaundice? What is the connection between jaundice and liver? Jaundice is an indication of a liver problem. Then what would be the answer? Don't tell me Valentine is to heart. Okay, so the answer would be rash is to skin. The answer would be rash is to skin. So these would be wrong. Answer would be rash is to skin, because rash is going to be a problem on skin. Similarly, jaundice is a problem on your liver. Question and the answer is on the screens for you. In another 10 seconds, we shall move to the next question. Okay. I hope you guys are clear with the explanation as well. Fine. Let's move on to the next question. Next question. Cobbler is to shoe. Cobbler is to shoe. Then what is to what? Is it jockeys to horse or contractor to building or what? Try to answer. Very simple. Try to answer. Another 10 seconds. I will reveal the answer for this question. It's very simple. I want all of you to answer in the live chat. Come on, folks. Give a try. Okay, then. Let me give the answer for this question. The answer would be contractor is to building. Okay. What is the connection? Cobbler makes and repairs shoe. Similarly, contractor builds and repairs building. So, answer would be option B. Contractor is to building. Fine. So, others are wrong. The question and the explanation is given to you in the next screens. And we shall move to the next question in another 10 seconds. Okay. Guys, my voice would not be very clear today. I'm really sorry for it. Okay. And if you hear any other sound other than my voice, once again, I'm sorry for that too. Okay, now let me move on to the next question. Very simple. Interest is to obsession. Now try to find the answer. What is the meaning of being obsessed? Try to eliminate the answer. Try to find the relationship and try to connect. Try to find the relationship, exact relationship between both the words and try to connect so that you will be able to find the answer. Okay. What is the meaning of the word interest and what is the meaning of the word obsession? What is the meaning of the word obsession? Think. So, in another 10 seconds, we shall move to the next question. I'll reveal the answer for this question. Fine. Think. Try to find the correct relationship. Folks, try to find the correct relationship. Okay. Now, what is the obsession? Obsession is a greater degree of interest. Okay. So, which option would be right? Which is going to be the greater degree of the first word? Answer would be dream is to fantasy. Answer would be dream is to fantasy, because fantasy is the higher degree of higher degree of dream. So answer would be dream is to fantasy. The question and the answer is now displayed to you on the screens. In another 10 seconds, we shall move to the next question. Fine. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Next question. Try to answer. Very simple. What is slapstick? Slapstick is basically comedy based. It's basically comedy based on clumsy actions. Clumsy or humorously embarrassing events. Clumsy actions or humorous events, okay? So, which should be closer to this? Try to answer. In another 10 seconds, I will be revealing the answer for this question. Slapstick is to laughter. Then what will be the answer? Try to think an answer. I want all of you to answer in the live chat. Slapstick is to laughter. Then the answer would be. Then the answer would be option E. Option E, horror is to fear. Because slapstick will result in laughter. So horror will result in fear. Right? The result is given in the next page. So answer would be option E. Horror is to fear. So let me move on to the next question. In another 10 seconds. Fine. I hope you guys understand this. Okay. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Next. Binding is to book. Find the answer for this. Binding is to book. Very simple. Binding is to book. Binding is to book. And then what is to what? Binding is to book. Try to find the relationship and then try to find. Binding is to book. Very simple, no? Okay. Come on, folks. Come on. Keep answering the live chat. Very good. Your efforts are appreciated. I will reveal the answer for this in another 10 seconds. Okay? Will that do good? So, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. The answer would be option E. Frame is to picture. Why? Because binding surrounds a book. Similarly, a frame surrounds a picture. So, answer would be option E, frame is to picture, because this is going to surround. Frame is going to surround the picture. Fine. Let me display the question and the answer for you. The question, the answer, and the explanation is on the screens right now for you. And we shall move to the next question in another. Maybe 10 seconds. Is that fine with you folks? I hope. Then. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay. Explore is to discover. I'll try to find the answer for this. Explore is to discover. Explore is to discover. Try to find the answer for this. Very, very simple. Give a try. Give a try. I will reveal the answer in another 10 seconds. Very simple. Give a try, folks. Explore is to discover. Then what is to what? Try to find the connection between the two words. Then you will be able to find the answer. Okay, then let me give you the answer. Okay, why does one explore? One explores to discover. Then what would be the closest option? Option would be, or the right option, the right option would be option B. Research is to learn. One researches to learn. One explores to discover. One researches to learn. So answer would be option B. Okay, the question and the answer is displayed on the screens for you right now. We shall move to the next question in another 10 seconds. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Division is to section. Oh my God, I have given the answer for this as well. Fine. Division is to section. Question and the answer is both I have given on the screens. So we shall do one thing. Please answer the attendance now. Kindly answer the attendance. The attendance link is provided in the live chat. I am really sorry if the sounds were disturbing you. And if you need any help, you can contact me in the live chat now. Please don't forget to like the video, share the video, and subscribe to our channel, Aptitude Guru Hem. I don't want to trouble you more with verbal. That's why I'm keeping the timings very short. I don't want to prolong this. I don't want to prolong this. Fine? So please answer the attendance. If you have any doubt, please drop it down in the live chat. And another 10 minutes, I will close this session. And thank you so much, friends. And I'm appreciating all your efforts. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Okay then, friends. Thank you so much. Have a great evening. Bye-bye. Take care. See you. Thank you so much for your support. Bye-bye. So I'm closing this session.